Cayuga Community Church, welcome. Whether this is your first time, or your 676th time, or somewhere in between, we're so glad you've chosen to join us today. 1 Chronicles chapter 29, verse 11 says, "Yours, O Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the majesty and the splendor, for everything in heaven and earth is yours." And so this morning our gathering song is called Majesty. But just before that, Robert Cockle has an announcement he'd like to share before he goes.
Okay, first the good news. I was in Montreal last weekend. I had a nice thing with Reverend Bob. He gave me some pictures posted on the back wall. On a sad note, I just got a phone call from Edgewater Gardens. Mother's in bad shape. She's in acceptable painkillers, and the end is here.
I'm sorry to begin our service like that. Robert really wanted to share that news himself, and so let's take a deep breath. And we'll include Mary and Robert in our prayers this morning as we worship, but let's stand as we are able and raise our voices in praise, singing together Majesty. Treaty as land long stewarded by the Haudenosaunee people. May this land acknowledgement remind us to be vigilant in pursuit of reconciliation and right relations with all of God's people. And may the light of this candle warm us and transform us, reminding us that Jesus, light of the world, is always with us, calling us to touch others with loving kindness, to shine hope where there is despair, to share light and love at each twist and turn of life. Our call to worship this morning is based on Psalm 133, and it is responsive, as we've been doing throughout the summer. So this morning, when I point to you, I want you to repeat after me how good it is to be together.
How good it is to be together.
How good it is to be together.
All right. How pleasant it is when siblings live together in unity.
How good it is to be together.
How wonderful, how beautiful when families get along.
How good it is to be together.
Harmony is precious, and no matter what has brought us here,
how good it is to be together.
Though we don't vote the same, or love the same, or think the same, we come together as one community.
How good it is to be together.
With gladness and thanksgiving, we gather together to worship here this morning. Let's pray. Holy God, we come seeking your understanding and compassion here in this sacred time, in this sacred place, upon this sacred and holy ground. We come wandering through the strains and stresses of this world, seeking rest and renewal. We come resisting the world and its ways, knowing you told us not to conform, so we come this morning looking for wisdom. Wrap us in your love. Show us your way. Open to us our hearts that we might be a blessing to your world. Amen. Our opening hymn this morning is number 508, Just As I Am. The words are going to be on the screen, and you can find it in Voices United. Number 508, Just As I Am.
Oh,
has been my favorite time during our worship services this morning, or this summer. I have loved hearing about your God moments. I was worried that folks wouldn't be open to participating, so I am so glad that you have all embraced telling your stories. Today we're going to take a little break from telling our moments or God winks. I got a text from a friend this week who shared a list with me called A Little Guide to Glimmers. Another name for God moments or God winks could be God glimmers. So I'd like to share this list with you today, and I want you to think about it over the next 2 weeks. And then come ready to share with us a God glimmer on September the 3rd. And this list will go out with Phyllis's mailing, so it will be right there for you to refer back to if you're struggling to find a God glimmer. So this is psychotherapist Helen Marie's guide to glimmers. Glimmers are the opposite of triggers. They are tiny moments of awe. They spark joy and evoke calm. They have a positive effect on our mental health. They are micro moments causing tiny mood shifts. They send cues of safety to our nervous system. They bring feelings of ease and contentment. Our body responds with positive energy. They allow us to feel hope when we're feeling lost. Our nervous system is strengthened by them. They can help increase our well-being. And once we start embracing them, it can become a beautiful way to see the world around you. God moments, or glimmers, or God winks are kind of like an I spy book. So I went to the library and I found some I spy books. And some of them are harder than others. This one says, I spy a shovel and a little toy horse. Can you find the shovel or the little toy horse? Not right away. It's a little bit tricky to find things because the page is so busy. There's so many things going on the page. So it's not that any of these other things on the pages are particularly bad. They're not evil or negative. There's just so much going on that it's hard to find what you're looking for. And that's kind of like life. There's so much going on in the world. There's so much going on in our day-to-day lives that we struggle to see those little tiny God glimmers or those little God winks because there's so much. So sometimes we miss seeing the hand of God or feeling God in the soft touch of a silky kitten's fur or the friendly smile of a stranger or the moon in the sky or the cheery song of a bird when you're walking to the mailbox or even the long-awaited prayer that's answered or the notes of the organ when it's playing your favorite hymn. Sometimes we miss those little things because there's so much other stuff. So this week, I really want you to pay attention to those little moments where God speaks to you, where you see God. May God find a special way to shine in your life today and tomorrow and in the weeks ahead, right where you are, in a way that is uniquely designed for you. If it's designed for me, it might be when I'm fishing. If it's designed for the artists in the room, it might be when you're creating or when you're driving the tractor in the fields. But a moment that's just designed for you, that God has given you that special wink or that special glimmer. So this morning, instead of singing, You Are Holy, we're going to pray. You are holy, you show us the way. And we're going to do it as a breath prayer. So when you breathe in, you are holy. And when you breathe out, You show us the way. So I want you to close your eyes if you're comfortable doing that. And as we breathe in, we say, you are holy. You show us the way. You are holy. You show us the way. Entranceway. If you want to grab some and bring them back to your seat, you're welcome to do that. And also, if anyone's falling asleep, you're also welcome to grab a coloring book and keep yourself awake that way. And I'm going to invite Linda Simons to come and share the scripture with us this morning.
Let us pray. Ever-loving and ever-stable God, we trust your steadfastness in these complex times. We cling to the assurance that you are constant, and at the same time, we are dependent on the promise that you are adaptable. As we reflect on ancient scripture today, may we catch glimpses of your amazing presence. Open our hearts that we might be aware of your blessing. Amen. The first scripture reading is Isaiah 40, verse 31. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. And they will walk and not be faint. The second reading is Isaiah 41, verse 10. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. And the last scripture reading, Lamentations 3, verses 22 to 26. Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for his compassions never fail. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. I say to myself, the Lord is my portion, therefore I will wait for him. The Lord is good to those who hope is in him, to the one who seeks him. It is good to wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord. For the word of God in scripture, the word of God among us, the word of God within our hearts. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Thanks, Linda. Let's sing again. Our hymn book is called Blessed Assurance. It's in the hymn book number 337 and will also be on the screen.
Jesus is mine, oh, what a glory.
meditations of our hearts bring you glory, holy God. Amen. Canadian-American public speaker and author Brian Tracy says, "The law of concentration states that whatever you dwell upon grows. The more you think about something, the more it becomes part of your reality. If you decide that you're in a terrible marriage, guess what your marriage will become. If you wake up and decide you're low on energy and you've got a headache and you feel lethargic and you want to take a nap, you're going to continue to feel more tired. If you tell yourself, I'm going to lose weight this time, I'm going to go on this diet, but I'm probably going to fall off and slip into my old bad habits, or I'm going to start this business, but I'm not very good at sales, and I probably won't be very good at this. I'm not very good at social media, so I'll probably fail. What's going to happen? It's likely that just by saying those things quietly in your head, they will come true. Whatever you think about, talk about, whatever you focus your attention and energy on becomes your reality. If you're thinking to yourself that people don't like me, people think I'm awkward, people don't like to be around me, or I'm being judged, all of those things become your reality. Is that what happened to the Israelites? They were rebellious, they were unkind, they were a disaster. The prophet Jeremiah tried to warn them. Those first scripture verses that Linda read were God's warning through Jeremiah that the people of Judah needed to repent and come back to God. It was a warning to the people of Judah about their negative and self-destructive ways and to replace that with hope. But they didn't listen. They didn't turn to God and change their ways. They kept on as they were, focused on themselves, and disaster struck. The people were conquered and captured by Babylon. The few that survived were wandering around starving. It was devastating. Jeremiah, or whoever wrote the book of Lamentations, was heartbroken for the nation of Judah. It's one of the darkest periods in biblical history. That was the third scripture that we heard this morning, a few verses from the book of Lamentations. Lamentations is a unique book of the Bible that has only five chapters. Each of the chapters are five distinct poems, and four of them are acrostic poems. Who knows what an acrostic poem is? Linda.
Where every letter at the beginning spells something, a word or whatever.
Exactly. So an acrostic poem is a poem in which certain letters of each line spell out a word, name, or phrase when read vertically. Most often, it's the first letter of each line that spells out the word, but they can be placed anywhere on the line. For example, using the word family, F, forgiving and always there for you, A, accepting no matter what, M, mother, I, integrity, doing what's right always, L, loving and caring for you, Y, you can depend on them always, so family. Similarly, but rather than using a word, the first, second, and fourth chapters of Lamentations correspond to the 22 letters of the Hebrew alphabet. The third chapter of Lamentations has 66 lines because each letter of the alphabet starts three lines. Chapter 3 is less about lamenting and more about hope for God's people and the promise of a new day, the promise of Jesus. Amid the sorrow and destruction, the author is writing about hope. Rather than focusing on what the author sees happening in Jerusalem or the smells of decomposition or the sounds of anguish, the writer is declaring what he knows about God. He knows that God's compassion never fails. He knows that God's mercies are new each and every day. He knows that God is good and faithful. Another guy who wrote about God's faithfulness and goodness despite tragedy was Thomas Obadiah Chisholm. Anyone know who that is? He was born in the state of Kentucky on July 29, 1866. Thomas never went to high school, but he became a teacher at the age of 16 at the little one-room schoolhouse where he himself had been educated. He loved writing poems, and at the age of 26, when he became a Christian, he began writing hymns. In 1903, he became an ordained minister with the Methodist Church, but was only in ministry for 1 year as his health began to fail. So he spent the next 5 years at home on the farm with his family and regained his strength, and then became an insurance agent until retirement, all the while writing over 1,200 poems, many of which became hymns. Despite all that Thomas endured throughout his life, he wanted his poetry and hymns to have truth and meaning, and he drew inspiration and ideas from the Bible. He wrote his most famous poem based on today's scripture, Lamentations chapter 3, verses 22 and 23. It is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because his compassions fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. What hymn do you think Thomas's poem became based on those verses? Great is thy faithfulness, yes. So if Thomas Obadiah Chisholm can work in the education system, the insurance industry and ministry, and write one of the most well-known hymns in the world, and the author of Lamentations can write not one, but five poems based on the Hebrew alphabet, particularly one so beautiful and profound that it inspires a great hymn, and become someone's favorite scripture lesson and someone's favorite hymn more than 2,500 years later, I think that we as a group can write one acrostic poem using our English alphabet. Despite all that is going on in our world right now, in this country, in our community and families, in our own lives, let's not focus on the negative. Let's not focus on all the stuff that can pull us down and distract us. Let's look for God moments, for God winks, for God glimmers, for the new days and bright hope that God promises. Let's come up with 26 words or phrases about God, A to Z. I did my homework in case we get stumped, but who's got a word or a phrase about God for A?
All-knowing.
All-knowing. Anyone want to add something?
Almighty.
Almighty. All-loving. Okay, B.
Blessed.
Blessed.
Behavior.
Pardon?
Behavior.
Behavior.
Born.
Born. Bountiful. Anyone else?
Beautiful.
Beautiful. C.
Courageous.
Courageous. decisive.
David.
David.
Delivers.
Bob, you're good at this. Delivers.
Constantly.
He's dependable. He's
delightful.
Justice. new mercies
from the scripture and the hymn.
Oh,
omnipotent, omnipresent,
obedient. Victory.
excellent exalter. Why?
You.
What's another name? We can put you. What's another name for God that starts with Y?
Yahweh.
Yahweh.
Your name.
Your name. And Z?
Zealous.
Zealous. Well,
we did it.
26 letters. More, way more than 26 words or phrases. So let's focus on these words and these phrases. Let's turn our eyes towards God. Let's train our brains to see God in all that surrounds us. Not to become blind or ignorant to the suffering of this world, but yet to recognize the glory of God, the zealous Zion, the caring comforter, the triumphant teacher in all things. God will renew us. God will strengthen and uphold us. God's compassions never fail. They are new each and every morning. The sun will set tonight and the sun will rise tomorrow morning. Even if it's overcast, even if it's raining, the sun is there behind the clouds, just as God is before us, behind us, beside us, and within us. God is with us. Thanks be to God. Amen. Let's pray. God of creation, God of infinite love and compassion, we come before you in awe and wonder. We ask that you would guide our eyes to see your holiness around us, that we might see all that is good and right, while also acknowledging all that is not, knowing that we live in a world where both beauty and danger surround us. So we offer to you now our prayers for all those struggling to see the beauty, grappling with ugliness, negativity, darkness, or chaos. Receive our prayers for those impacted by and living in fear of the wildfires across Canada and the world, for all who cannot find adequate food, safety, or shelter, for all who have lost their homes, churches, community centers, and workplaces, for all your glorious natural creation that has been destroyed and is in harm's way, for all things, places, and people that are in need of healing. We pray and ask that you help heal the pain of all affected. Strengthen with your presence all who are numb with fear and distress. Guide those who anxiously search or wait for loved ones. Be near those who are grieving and bless them with your peace. In the midst of disaster, we give thanks for moments of generosity and human kindness. Grant tenderness, strength, and wisdom to doctors and nurses, police and military, firefighters, and emergency responders, to the wildlife conservationists and stewards of the earth, to all who minister to human need in our time of distress. Holy God, we pray for all those who may not be caught in wildfires, but who feel they are alone in the wilderness. The wilderness of grief from the loss of loved ones, the loss of relationship, the loss of employment, the changing of the seasons, becoming empty nesters or leaving for school, the wilderness of a new school or a new job, the wilderness of financial strain, of health concerns, of devastating diagnosis, of treatment plans, of new medications or overwhelming decisions. Wrap them in your comforting embrace. Give them courage and strength. Remind them that they are never alone. We lift in prayer this morning all those whose names are on our South Cayuga Community Church prayer list, including all our church members living in long-term care homes, in retirement and nursing homes, all those who are away on holiday and those who are resting at home, and all those known to us whom we hold dear. We pray this morning especially for Mary Cockle and for Robert, We pray for the staff at Edgewater. We lift to you now, Holy God, all those names and loved ones that we hold dear now in the silence of our hearts. We gather these prayers with the assurance that you already know our needs and are always with us. Together, we offer to you the words that Jesus said together with his friends, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The sign on the front lawn has been changed since I was here on Thursday, because on Thursday when I pulled into the church, I noticed that the sign said something like, "Don't come to church." And I waited to see what would come next, knowing it was going to be good. And it said, "Be the church." Perfect. So thanks to Bob for his sign ministry. It was much appreciated. So be the church. How are we being the church? We're collecting food for the food bank. We served dozens of families 3 weeks ago through Wonder Camp. Our prayer team is praying on a regular basis for over 20 people on our prayer list. There are so many ways that we are being the church in this community and beyond. Our offerings to the church and the United Church Mission and Service Fund is one more way that we can be the church. So let us be generous. Let us receive the offering.
Thank you.
God. You call us to deep spirituality, bold discipleship, and daring justice. May these gifts help us to be the people and the church you long for us to be. Bless these gifts and those offered through PAR and online, and multiply them for the sake of ourselves and the world. Amen. I invite you to be seated, and we'll take a quick look at the announcements. Please join in having coffee after church today. I won't be there. I'm going to run straight to Hagersville after church. My son Brady is playing ball in the championship game. They're starting right now, so I'd like to catch the tail end of it. But please stay for coffee after church. A very big thank you, and I forgot to do this a couple of weeks ago, but very big thank you to Gord Hauser for the donation of a basketball net, and to Daryl Cavers and to Andy for installing it. It was a big hit at Wonder Camp. I'm hopeful that it will be something for the Sunday school kids, something for the neighborhood to just come and play basketball in the parking lot. And maybe someday it will lead to us also painting some lines and getting a portable one, and we can have a real game, or who knows what can come of it. But it's a great start for us to be a community place where families can come and play and be comfortable here. So thanks to those gentlemen who helped make that happen. This week, the Lunch Bunch is heading to Caruso's in Cayuga. Everyone is invited to come for lunch. You order your own lunch and you pay for your own lunch, and there's no agenda. We just enjoy one another's company. So that's on Tuesday at 12:15 in Caruso's this week. And if you're there, then you get a say in where they go the next week. So if you have a place you'd like to go, you have to come on Tuesday and share it with the group, and then they'll decide where they're going to go the next week. Are there any other announcements folks would like to draw attention to?
My dad, Jim, we're all celebrating his
80th
birthday
yesterday. Wonderful. Happy birthday to Jim. Wendy? Faithfulness. to share hope where there is despair, and to reflect the light and love of Jesus.